Hey everyone, this is Bridget, and today we're going to be talking about the three things you need to know about shadow work. So we'll get into it in just a second. Briefly, shadow work is going into our shadow. So maybe our dark side, our unconscious, those things that we pushed out, and bringing them to conscious awareness so that we can become more whole again. So these are three things that you really need to know as you're deep diving and going into this subject. They're all quite surprising, things you probably haven't heard before, but I've learned through experience and working with so many people. And comment below if you have done some shadow work, if you're like experienced with this, or if you're new. So the first thing that I want to talk about is that as we raise our vibration, it exposes more of our shadow. Now, this is such an important concept. I don't hear a lot of people talking about it, so I wanted to share it with you because it's been up for me. So I'm gonna share a little bit of a story so that you can understand what I'm talking about and then how to utilize it. Because it's really important to understand these waves of energy, these waves of what we're going through, and these tips will really help you navigate that. So I just finished our 7-day retreat in Hawaii. We went to Maui and Kauai. It was an incredibly loving group, and seriously, the vibration for me of Hawaii just like takes me to a whole other level. And particularly this time, I just freaking was blasted. Just my heart, my energy, I experienced some of the highest vibrations I've ever experienced. And as I put myself into these immersive situations that just kind of like accelerate and expand your energy very, very quickly, which I've done for years. I kind of love doing it. Just like pumping up the energy and like blasting open to a new level. And I've been doing this for years. At first it was going on different retreats or visiting different sacred sites myself. And then it became hosting and facilitating them. But one of the things that I noticed as this happened from the very beginning of when I first started traveling and stuff is that when we go to these high levels, and this might be through a breathwork process, this might be through a meditation, this might be through plant medicine, this might be through whatever it is that you're going through, you might blast yourself to a higher level, but then often what happens is you're like spinning like this, but then the world around you, you know, like your previous life, right? The energy of your life is like at this other speed. Let's see if I can do this. And what you're doing is you're coming back into this and it's like, whoa, and you actually like speed up your previous reality, your previous life, and your habits, the people you're around, your job, whatever that is. And so it all of a sudden gets this light, this accelerated energy shined on it. And then that reveals things. The shadow is thus revealed. So this is really important to note, because if you're wanting to explore shadow work and go into it, but you're like, I don't even know, like, how do I look into it? I mean, there's lots of different methods, and I have another video on that, which is really, really helpful. But one tip just quickly is by doing this, is by raising your vibration, then it automatically brings up those things that are out of alignment or that have been in the shadow kind of lurking that are ready to come up to our awareness to look at and to work through. And so this is what happened to me. And I kind of went through a, 3-day shadow dark night of the soul, which I love talking about the subject because lots of you probably are like, whoa, she's just positive all the time. And I think that one of the reasons I am so positive or like can stay in a bright energy is because I go into the shadow, which seems counterintuitive, which we'll get into in a minute. But the idea that it brought up my stuff, or and it brought up some sub and unconscious kind of dark lurking energies that were happening in some of my close relationships. And so I got to look at it, but I knew it was coming. Like, I knew that I was on a high. I didn't expect it. Like, maybe I was just gonna get home and everything was just gonna be super bright and shiny and that would be great. But in this case, I was like, okay, things might be revealed. And so I welcomed it rather than resisting it. And because I did that, I moved through it very, very quickly. And the other thing is as I had these heightened states of energy and then had this shadow stuff come up, it was met with equal, incredible high opportunity that just came at the same exact time. So it can also obviously bestow wonderful gifts as well. But it might reveal things that you need to shift in your own life, relationships you need to change, things about yourself that are now irrelevant and changed and new. And so you're a new person and you might have to adapt to that. So just understanding that as you accelerate and raise your energy, it may reveal the dark shadows. The second thing that's so important to know about shadow work is that these shadow aspects are locked up potential energy. All right? It's really important to understand. So as we dig around, what we're actually digging for is we're truly mining for gold. We are mining for the treasures of our soul in shadow work. It sounds strange, but it's really true because as I've worked with so many people on this, the most precious, the most powerful, the most sensitive, the most kind of passionate and spunky and all these parts of our soul are in the shadow. So when we have experiences, whether they're from this life primarily and some from other lives that create these, distorted or suppressed energies, anything, of course, that is us that then is pushed into the dark or pushed away where it can't be seen or it is out of conscious awareness, thus becomes shadow. And in moments of trauma or challenge or whoa, this is too much, those parts of us get pushed away. And it can be partly a survival mechanism. It can be partly that it's not safe to reveal those parts. There's lots of different reasons. Just understanding that as we go and look for them and we bring them back into the light, they are really, really special. They might be like feisty and, kind of hurt or these certain energies for a moment, but as we meet them with love and compassion and truly sharing that we need those aspects of ourselves, they will come back to be our greatest allies as we come and return to wholeness. There was a great movie, can't remember the name. It was like a cartoon movie with like a witch, and there was like this witch kind of like taking over the village, and it was kind of demonically, haunting the whole village. But as these kids like went to pursue the witch, what they found was this little precious girl that was just like sad and scared and didn't get to be included. And so that is a really good example of what we actually find as we go dig around. And also these are latent potential energies, because when we think of shadow, we think of dark, and dark usually means underworld. And sometimes we do need to go to the underworld to retrieve them because that's where we've thrown them and cast them out. But nonetheless, these sub and unconscious energies or aspects of ourselves are often really amazing energy. So as we bring them up, they're not like lower energy, they're actually higher energy that actually just couldn't exist in this world at this time for whatever reason. So that's very important to remember. So go treasure hunting. The third thing you need to know about shadow work is that it doesn't need to become a part of your identity or something that you go lurk around in, right? You don't need to have permanent residency in the shadow to be doing your shadow work. This is important because I think it's one of those things where it has, and it happens with certain people that have kind of a natural tendency to the dark, right? Or tendency to the underworld. But it's really important to understand that it is awesome to go exploring, down there and like within here. But it doesn't always need to be that. It's meant to go, we're going on a journey into the mystery of ourselves where we're navigating through these waters. But what we're meant to do is bring it back into wholeness and then become lighter and then become brighter. And one of the things that happens is when our attention, when our awareness, when our consciousness focuses too much in the shadow, it becomes shadow. And then it becomes like distorted and demented, and it's kind of strange, And this happens when you can hear people talking about like, my inner child is just still so sad and wounded, and it's kind of like slightly demented. It's like, no. Yes, the inner child or these certain aspects of ourselves need attention. Absolutely. They need care. They need attention, but they don't have to, like, stay in this, like, wounded form. Do you know what I mean? You, like, are aware of it, and then you bring it up, but then it's not, like, staying wounded. It's like, okay, what can I bring to this piece of me to bring it back to life, to bring it back to its true nature, to its true essence? And so that's really what we're seeking. And so I often see a lot of people kind of, like, staying in the muck, you know, and you might be kind of more of an underworld navigator, and that's super cool. Like, that's certain people's tendency, but it's really important not to be fueled by death. I guess you could say, like, you can be powered by source and light, or you can be powered by death. And just remembering that death is a fuel source to transform, but it isn't the primary space where you are sourced into life. So those are my top three tips. Be sure to go check out my other video for more really good tips of how to get in there and navigate it. And I really appreciate you watching. Please comment below and let me know where you're at on your shadow work journey. And be sure to subscribe to this channel. Hit the bell button so you get notifications every time I do new videos. And I really appreciate you watching. I'll see you next time with another video.